Hi friends, welcome to Testacus for Careers. Today we are going to see about time and work. Let's see some important facts in time and work. A completes a work in n days, then A's one day work is 1 by n. Suppose A can finish a work in 3 days, then A's one day work is 1 by 3. That is, A will do 1 by 3rd of the work on the first day, 1 by 3rd of the work on second day, and the remaining 1/3 of the work on the third day. He'll complete the whole work in 3 days. If A's one day work is 1 by n, then A completes a work in n days. A can do a work in 20 days, B can do the same work in 30 days. We have to find out in how many days A and B can complete the work together. Work done in 1 day by A is 1 by 20 and by B is 1 by 30. So adding the work done in 1 day by A and B, that is 1 by 20 plus 1 by 30, we get the work done by A and B in 1 day, which is equal to 1 by 12. And we know that the days taken by A and B to complete the work is the inverse of the work done in 1 day by A and B. That is, the inverse of 1 by 12 is 12 days. This is the time taken by A and B to complete the work together. We can also solve this by taking the LCM of 20 and 30, which is 60. 60 is the total units of work which has to be done by A and B. So in 1 day, A can do 3 units of work and B can do 2 units of work. Totally, A and B can do 5 units of work in a day. So they can complete 60 units of work in 12 days. Let's see another problem. A can do a work in 10 days and B can do in 15 days. We have to find out in how many days can A and B complete the work together. The work done in 1 day by A is 1 by 10 and by B is 1 by 15. So the work done in 1 day by A and B is 1 by 10 plus 1 by 15, which is 1 by 6. So A and B can together do 1 by 6 of work in 1 day. So inversing it, we can find out the number of days A and B takes to complete the work. That is 6 days. A and B can complete the work together in 6 days. Let's solve it by finding the LCM of 10 and 15. The LCM of 10 and 15 is 30. So 30 units of work has to be completed by A and B. In 1 day, A can do 3 units of work and B can do 2 units of work. Totally, A and B can do 5 units of work. They have to complete 30 units of work. So they'll take 6 days to complete 30 units of work. A can do a work in 7 days of 9 hours and B can do in 6 days of 7 hours. We'll convert the total time taken by A into hours. That is, for 7 days, A does 9 hours of work. That is, A can do a work in 63 hours and B can do the same work in 42 hours. We have to find out how long they will take to complete the work together, working 8 and 2 by 5 hours a day. So in 1 hour, the work done by A is 1 by 63 and by B is 1 by 42. So the work done in 1 hour by A and B is 1 by 63 plus 1 by 42, which is 5 by 126. inversing it, we can find the time taken by A and B to complete the work. That is nothing but 126 by 5 hours. Here they were asked the time taken by A and B if they work 8 and 2 by 5 hours a day. So we will divide 126 by 5 by 8 and 2 by 5 and we will get 3 days. So time taken by A and B to complete the work working 8 and 2 by 5 hours a day is 3 days. Now let's solve the problem by taking the LCM of 63 and 42, which is 126. The total units of work which has to be done by A and B is 126. A can do 2 units in 1 hour and B can do 3 units in 1 hour. So totally they can do 5 units in 1 hour. So the time taken by A and B to do 126 units is 126 divided by 5 hours. If they work for 8 and 2 by 5 hours a day, they will complete the work in 3 days. That is, we divide 126 by 5 by 42 by 5 and we get 3 days. A can do a work in 10 days, B can do the same work in 12 days and C in 15 days. We have to find out in how many days A, B, C can complete the work together. The work done in one day by A is 1 by 10, B is 1 by 12 and C is 1 by 15. The work done in one day by A, B and C is 1 by 10 plus 1 by 12 plus 1 by 15, which is equal to 1 by 4. The time taken by A, B and C to complete the work is the inverse of the work done in one day by A, B and C. That is, the inverse of 1 by 4 is 4 days. So A, B and C takes 4 days to complete the work together. Let's find out by finding the LCM of 10, 12 and 15. The LCM of 10, 12 and 15 is 60. So 60 units of work has to be done by A, B and C. In one day A can do 6 units of work, B 5 units and C 4 units. Totally they can do 15 units of work in a day. They have to complete 60 units of work. So they will take 4 days to complete the work. That is, we divide 60 by 15 and we get 4 days. A can do a work in 15 days, B in 20 days and C in 12 days. We have to find out in how many days A, B, C can complete the work together. The work done in one day by A is 1 by 15, by B is 1 by 20 and C is 1 by 12. The work done in one day by A, B and C together is 1 by 15 plus 1 by 20 plus 1 by 10, which is equal to 1 by 5. The time taken by A, B and C to complete the work is inverse of the work done in one day by A, B and C. So finding the inverse of 1 by 5, we have 5. So A, B and C takes 5 days to complete the work. Let's solve by finding the LCM of 15, 20 and 12. That is, the LCM of 15, 20 and 12 is 60. The total units of work which has to be done by A, B and C is 60. A does 4 units of work in a day, B 3 units and C 5 units. Totally, they do 12 units of work in a day. They can complete 60 units of work in 5 days. That is, 60 divided by 12 will give 5. So A, B and C takes 5 days to complete the work. A and B can do a work in 9 days, B and C in 12 days and A and C in 18 days. We have to find out in how many days A, B and C can complete the work separately and together. First, we'll find out the time taken by A, B, C together to complete the work. The work done in one day by A and B is 1 by 9, by B and C is 1 by 12, and C and A is 1 by 18. So, we'll add the work done in one day by A and B, B and C, and C and A. That is 1 by 9 plus 1 by 12 plus 1 by 18. When adding, we get 2A plus 2B plus 2C, which is equal to 1 by 4. So, A plus B plus C is 1 by 8. So, the work done in one day by A, B and C is 1 by 8. And the time taken by A, B and C to complete the work is the inverse of the work done in one day by A, B and C. That is, the inverse of 1 by 8 is 8. So, A, B and C takes 8 days to complete the work. Now, let's find the work done by A in one day. For finding the work done by A in one day, we have to subtract the work done by B and C in one day from the work done by A, B and C in one day. And we get 1 by 24. 1 by 24 is the work done by A in one day. The time taken by A to complete the work is the inverse of the work done in one day. That is, the inverse of 1 by 24 is 24. A takes 24 days to complete the work. For finding the work done in one day by B, we subtract the work done by A and B in one day from the work done by A, B and C in one day, and we get 5 by 72. The work done by B in one day is 5 by 72. The inverse of 5 by 72 will give the number of days B takes to complete the work. That is, B will take 72 by 5. That is 14 and 2 by 5 days to complete the work. For finding the work done by C in one day, we have to subtract the work done by A and B in one day from the work done by A, B and C in one day. That is, we get 1 by 72. The work done by C in one day is 1 by 72. And the time taken by C to complete the work is the inverse of the work done by C in one day. The inverse of 1 by 72 is 72. C takes 72 days to complete the work. Hope you find this video useful. If so, please like, comment, share and subscribe. We will meet with new information. Thanks for watching.